What is up the world? It is your friendly neighborhood Slipgator here. And today we're hanging out, doing some things over at the new 1-8, of course. Got some different ideas about some stuff and things we're going to do today. So I did some changes, made some small off-camera changes. Added four more of the biofuel reactors. Biofuel reactors from, these are taken from the quarry. And yeah, so also tore apart the 16K storage drives I had and turned them all into 64s. We have storage for days, and that's the way I like it. You know, I don't mind using the deep stores, but I don't even know if we need them, to be honest with you. But I think we're still going to use them for now. But yeah, also I ended up putting the bottom on to the new 1-8. So this is what she's going to look like-ish. I still have some more stuff and things I want to do. So added the bottom section on. Let me just bring you over here and show you. This is a new block too. We'll show you that in a second. But so down here just looks like this, just a floor, some stuff and things. And then up at the top, I've added just the upper floor here. There's a lot more building to be done on the new 1-8. A lot more building to be done. But we're just taking it slow. We're taking it a little bit slowly. We don't have to get it all done in an instant. It's a big build. But down inside of here, I've added the cabling that we're going to use. Now, I actually really thought about this for quite a while. I was like, I could place it in two back corners. I could place it in these sides. Where should I place the cable to make it the most efficient spot? And I think that the inside here where I've done it is really going to be the best spot for it. Now, down here, I've added these block of quartz illusions. And they're really cool blocks. So if we take a look at these illusion blocks, you can see there's the block of quartz illusion. And what it is a block of quartz with the Eye of Ender. And they're all that way, I do believe. Everything is just a block with the Eye of Ender. You put it on, basically what it is what you've seen. It's the appears as to be the full block, but you can just pass through it. Now, unfortunately, there's no block of marble illusion. So I'm using the quartz blocks down here. And this is, I don't know if it's temporary or permanent, but I may actually even put like a doorway section thing around it to make it look a little bit more special. But I was thinking about kind of the orientation. That was another thing. I was like, where is the front of the 1-8? Which part is the front part? So, and I was kind of feeling like this was the front, like this is how you would come to it. But I feel like a fundamental shift has happened. Oh, look, way better. I mean, does it really matter? I don't think it really matters. But I think this is going to end up being what we consider to be our front. So we need to take those out eventually. But what I wanted to do today is I wanted to get, at the very least, I want to get so many things done. But at the very least, what I want to get done today is I want to get the AE system moved over. So, and that creates kind of a chain reaction. So the AE system getting moved over means I got to get the power system moved over. And then once the AE system's moved over, I also need to get the deep storage system moved over. And I just need to get a lot of the stuff and things moved over. I don't want it to be here in the ghetto base anymore. I feel like we've just risen above it. It's just, we're just better than this. So we got the ender chests. And let's go ahead and craft two of these guys. And then let's get some, what dyes do we have? What's going on with me tonight? Let's go with just white dye. So I think we can just place this guy down. Oh, you know what else we're going to need? Diamonds. Two diamonds like so. Bam. Do I shift it? Or are they all, is this already white? I thought they were like blank and then we could, what am I thinking? Let's go with black and then just black center. All right, and then let's private this thing. Make it privates. There, now it's privates. Can I shift click on this with this? No. Bam. Privates. All right, so let's put these guys away, put these guys away. Let's get all of this cleaned out. And then need some apples. We're running low on fuel. And then arrows, I don't even have my bow on, and I have not been using it for quite a while, so we'll take care of that. I'm like an inventory Nazi, guys. It is crazy. So I think what we're going to do first is move this guy over. So we don't really need, what I want to use the ender chest for is for moving the Mac because of all the pages. So the Mac's going to go down here somewhere. So we'll put that there for when we do that. But the first thing we have to do is move this. Now, nothing is coming into or out of the ME system. We're perfectly fine to just shut this bad boy right off. It doesn't even matter. There's no need. But for now, we'll leave it turned on. Especially, I guess there's one reason we might want to have it turned on, is so that we can like get into it if we need items. But the first thing that I want to do is kind of create, see, like this. We might need some items. I want to create the power system. Now, I would like to, I was thinking about putting a couple things up top here. One of them being the assembly chamber, but I think we might build, I don't know. The assembly chamber needs to go in the base somewhere. But I think that we can either put the assembly chamber up here. The Mac is going to go here. So the Mac will be 5x5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, wait. I hope you guys are having a good day. Did I say that? I hope that you guys are having a good day. I just always hope that. So, yeah, anyway, 5x5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's where the Mac's going to be. Like so. So this will be the outline of the Mac. Oh, no, here. Like this. And I didn't want to do it. I wanted to do it directly under. Oh, you know what? The reason that I wanted to do it directly under, or didn't want to, yeah, I can't, actually, because of this. We can't get up and down from here without it. But we still can use these, so maybe we can put it right up inside of there. That would be pretty rad, right? Like the Big Mac just kind of hanging out underneath. We'd need to put a space, at least one space, in between for the wiring to move around down here. Yeah, that might be a really good spot for it, though. Okay, so let's figure out a way to get that to happen. We'll move the Mac over there. But firstly, so that, all right, if we're going to move the Mac there, then we have room to Jenny power down here. Now, all right, I want to leave this. I have a plan for over here, too. So right now, you can't go down any further. In fact, if you wanted to get out, you'd have to kind of go out like this. But what I'm thinking about doing is making, since all these chunks are going to be loaded, we're going to be using chunk loaders and all that stuff and things, I'm thinking about making a tunnel that goes down and maybe having something underneath here. So I want to future-proof that by making sure that, like this, this area. Ooh, let's get up here. We can do it. I believe in us. Like so. And then just actually removing this. So what we'll do is have a clear glass kind of avenue area that goes down all the way to the ground here, to the bottom of the ocean. And then we'll be able to use the elevators to come down here. And this is just, I'm anticipating possibly needing more room, and this is just a good spot to do it. Now, I want to use the other islands for stuff and things as well, and that's going to be a thing. I mean, we're going to use those other islands too. But I just feel like this is going to end up being a thing. Like so. Bam. And then if we go down inside of here, we can empty this guy out just that easily. So now if we were to put a elevator block here, which I don't know, do I have any extras? I don't think I do. Let's go back over to the, where am I? Let's see if we have any in the system. I think we might not, but we can pop one down real quick. Let's just craft one. And then we'll plop it down real quick, just so we can get the effect. Just so, you know, it'll be a thing. Oh, wait, did I build this? Oh, damn! Damn you, measuring. All right, so this is all fail. All right, so I'll tell you what. What I want to do, I got to move that and fix it. I'll do that off camera. But then what I'm going to do next is also begin to down in here, I think, is where we're going to do it. We're going to put our Power Jenny. I was thinking about doing it up there, but I think down here. We're going to put the Mac and the Power Jenny and get the AE system moved over. Now, I'm going to do that off camera, and when I have that kind of completed, I will come back and show you guys how I've got it all set up. All right, I got some stuff and things torn down, some stuff going on down there, so just so you can see, but I want to kind of do some of the stuff on camera with you guys too. So look, the old base is broke down. I got the whole Mac done except for the pattern providers. When I break these guys, all the patterns should spill out, but and that's going to be a problem for us, and that's why we're going to use this thing here. So I probably should clean up my inventory before doing this slip. Be smart. We'll do that late after. But this is, I think, the best way to do this. And actually, Hypno kind of had recommended this. He was like, when you move stuff around, you could use Ender Chests. And I was like, it might be a little bit longer to do that, but not with these patterns. This is absolutely a faster way to do this. So let me clean this up like so. Let's go back over to the 1.8 and throw some of this stuff in the system. We don't need that. Yo, bam, bam. One of those, and one of those, and one of those. And we'll put the rest of the stuff in here, like so. All right, so let's go back and grab this. Then now, did I lose any? So that was just one of the pattern providers, and it's already, I think, pretty much filled this guy up. So in order to move this over, what we're going to need to do, I guess I'll just show this to you now. Maybe I'll do the moving over off camera. I thought it was going to be a little bit quicker, but it's going to take a little bit of time. So we'll stick that guy in there. Then we can go ahead and grab these patterns out of the Ender chest like so, and we can come up in here and stick them all inside like this. So you actually don't need to use the Mac interface to do it. You can just do it straight with the pattern provider like so. But here's the new power system that I've got set up. There's our jailed up cow. We gotta name that cow, get him a name tag maybe. Actually, wait, are there name tags even? Are we at name tag level? Yes, okay, we have name tags. I didn't know. I can't remember if they're in this version or not. But so we got those guys on with four of the biofuel generators, and I took the three redstone energy cells I had and then hooked them up to the system. And so we're good to go there. So now I got to get everything moved over from the Mac into the system, and then we should kind of have a majority of our stuff and things moved over. Let's see if I can get lucky. I wonder how it does these. Oh, it does them west-facing. And it looks like these are the first things I did. So it looks like it does them west-facing from north to south. Just a little piece. That's kind of interesting. So I plop this guy down. We're going to get a bunch of those. And then, you know what? Let's just break that. Take it. Stick it down here. It's going to be a lot easier to work with. Like so. And then we can just stick all these guys inside. Oh, man. There's a lot of them. All right. So I'm going to move the rest over, the last couple. And then when I get that done, I'll come back to you guys. All right. Moment of truth. But not really. But I'm pretty sure everything should be fine. And I think that what should happen is this would be page one now. This is page two. This is page three. Let's see if it's consistent. I'm not sure if it's consistent. I'm interested to see that if it is or not. Bam. It's a Mac. Go up. Thank you. And then let's take a look and wait, we have to look in the Mac. Oh, am I not close enough to hit that? Oh, really? That's kind of a pain in the nuts. Didn't anticipate that. Two, three. Yeah, so that's exactly how it works. Interesting. Very interesting. And I only accidentally shift-clicked one of the patterns and erased it. So that's the best thing ever. But not even at all. So the other thing that I wanted to do, I have 30 of these fence posts, and I was kind of wondering what this would look like. Let's take a look here and see if we did posts up through here like so. Oh, they don't attach to the Mac. That is good. Like this. I think this might actually be a cool thing. It might just kind of look neat down inside of here. We can stack these like so. Yeah. Oh, that looks good. I really like that. It's gonna. Can you walk through here? Unfortunately, yes. What happens if we do this? Ugh, don't like it. Maybe we'll use a full block instead. So that we can't, I don't know. Let me see. Let's take a look. Oh, that is not how you spell marble. Not even a little bit. So, oh, we could use the green. Yeah, maybe. Let's try these gray inverted lamps instead. We'll stack them too high so we can't walk over them. Do we like that? What do you think? Because it attaches, which is, meh. I don't know. I don't know if I like the attachment very much, but we can really easily come up here and use it. Well, kind of, sort of. It looks like you need a lot of full blocks in order to make it kind of maybe work a little bit better. Maybe we can do like we did up there. Something like this. We'll just walk right over it, though. What? That's the problem. So we may need to just put marble like this. Oh, it attaches. And then you can... Oh, it still walks up over. Man! Well, I will have a think about it as far as how we can kind of make that look a little better. Maybe, actually. Let's take a look at this. Oh, it all attaches all the way down. Oh, it's kind of modernish. Do we walk over it? See, you still walk up over this, which is a huge pain in the butt. We'd have to do... maybe like so. And then continue this down with just posts. I want it to kind of maintain a really modern look. Yeah, it kind of looks like bases, like a base to a pillar type thing. And then you can go right inside. That's nice. I like that. I think it's pretty cool. Yeah, yeah. So maybe we'll recreate that over three other times. And then I got to see, do we have drives already programmed in here? We do. Let's go ahead and get three more of these drives going. I'm going to put three on the other side. And I think that honestly should be possibly all the drives that we ever need. The crafting monitor up here. You're working, aren't you there, big guy? You're currently crafting one chest. Do we have a crafting loop going on here? Wood. It doesn't say it's missing a chest. There's the recipe for the chest. It says it's currently crafting one chest. Oh, what's going on? Let's try it one more time. Something's wrong, and it has to do most likely with that pattern that I erased, which is the best thing that could have ever happened. So, yeah, something's not right. Great. That really stinks. I have no idea which one of these patterns I erased. I assumed that it would just tell me, but it's not telling me. It's going to be a huge pain in the butt to figure out what's wrong. That sucks. Well, it's probably something to do with the ME drive, so I can go back through and take a look at all the things that are required in order to make it and see what's going on and see what's wrong. All right, I'm going to play around with it. I'll be back in just a second. Get this guy fixed. So almost finished with the kind of scaffolding we're doing there. There we go. Bam, it's done. Nope, it's not. It's not the thing yet. So just going to use these fences here. And I didn't really, I showed you over there this marble fence. And here it is right here. If we take a look at it, I wanted to show you how you make it. It is... like that. So you need to actually make the marble posts and marble pillars, and those are done using the like a saw. You can use whatever saw you want, but if you take these and then cut them in half with the saw on top, cut them in half with the saw on the side, you're going to get the marble pillars. If you cut them on the top again, you'll get the marble posts, and that's how you craft those fiances in that pattern right there like that. So yeah, let's go ahead and get this finished up here. And I was just thinking of kind of what my next step is. We got the deep stores we got to get moved over to, and I want to get ME crafting terminals set. Bam! It's a thing. So I want to get ME crafting monitors set up for those as well. So if we take a look at the crafting monitor recipe, let's take a look at what we're going to need for that. We need more of these ME basic processors. We need a lot of those. And I can't remember if I showed you guys this last time. Super cheaty way to do this. So... you can take the basic processor assembly. So if you look at the processor, basic processor assembly, you can, here it is right here, with the quartz cutting knife, which now the ME system uses crafting materials that require damage value and durability, so we're good to go. We can make these basic processors. And then you saw you can use Mimikite to take an uncooked or an unsmelted basic processor and turn it into two of the smelted basic processors. So this is... it's fairly cheaty, and it works with the advanced processor assemblies as well. So bam, bam, you can see there. Really, I don't know. I don't know if that should be a thing. So I tore down some of the machines we have back over at the ghetto area and the ender chest as well. We're going to stick all this stuff in the system, put the iron thingy-doodler back in there, and then one of these, one of these, one of these, and then one of these. I will leave that for now. So the next thingy-doodler I was going to do, what was I talking about doing? I just lost my train of thought completely. Scream at me about it. It's going to build a thing that used processors. What was I going to do? Let's go back down here. I can't even remember now. Oh my God, I'm getting old. I'm so old. I feel sad and old and feeble. So I'm a bit of an idiot, but actually what I was talking about was ME storage monitors, and those mean that we need to have the recipe for these, but also for the level emitters, which does mean we need the basic processors. So, okay, yeah, that's a thing. I'm also going to need to set up a way to automatically input the recipes into the Mac, and that's something that Hypno did last season. It had a really cool design, so I'm going to use that. We got to get that set up here at some point. It doesn't have to be right now. So we got 10 deep storage units. So what are these called again? They're ME storage monitors. So if we take a look at the storage monitors, pardon me, in here, monitors, derp. Let's get 10 of those going, and I'll be surprised if we have all the things we need. Is everything going to work? This feels like it's like a real thing. It's like a professional system here, man. This is like real deal. So let's go ahead and grab the 10 of these guys, and then we got to go back and pick up the deep stores. And I can't remember. I think you can just I don't really play around with these very much. Let's take one of the smaller ones. Do we wrench them? Okay, phew. I don't know if you have to wrench them or what the dealio is. That's kind of cheaty. You could just wrench a bunch of things and like, you could store stuff in them and wrench them and stick them in a chest. That's a really interesting way to store things. Yeah, sorry, newbie. Bit of a noob. But that's fine. It's fine. So we're going to take these guys up here. And one of the cool things about, we might as well grab this stuff too. We don't really need it here anymore. One of the cool things about, we'll leave that in case when we set up our next quarry. One of the cool things about the deep stores and the ME crafting terminals and the way that this column is going to work is that this is exactly 5 wide. So unfortunately, we can't really use the first couple of levels because I got to be able to get these storage buses in behind the deep store units unless... Can we face these like so? We can. And now that the deep stores aren't derpy, we should be able to draw in and out of them from the back. They used to be you have to configure them by side, but I don't believe that's the case anymore. So we should be able to go ahead and do like this. Take out 2 rows. Go ahead and put our deep stores in. Now, unfortunately, I didn't... I surely should order these in order of amountedness. So stone is the biggest. Stick that here. Well, and then I'll tell you what. We'll get our 10 crafting monitor, or 5 crafting monitors like this. Then we'll have another row of deep stores here. And then 5 more of the storage monitors, pardon me, here. Oh, like so. And I am going to try to order these in order of from highest to lowest, the amount stored. It is going to take me a second to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and get these ordered, get them hooked up, and then bring you back and show you the amazingness. Okay, so now you can see back here we've got everything hooked up to the system. And then if we go ahead and like so, one of these, one of those, one of them, and one of those. We're good to go there. And then just to make sure, let's nicely place these up. 2, 3, 4, 5. And then go like one of these, one of them, one of those, one of those, one of those. And then we'll take our wrench. So I'm just right-clicking on each one of the storage monitors in order for it to clone or mirror the item that I have in my inventory. And then it's going to display how many of those are in the ME system. And if we shift click each one of these, we're going to lock them so we can't accidentally click them with another item in order to make them display a different item. And we're good to go. There's 10 of them there. Now I think we actually might be able to use the system, or I may decide to take and add maybe 5 more deep stores. Let's stick all this stuff in here. So I think we might add 5 more deep storage units to the mix here. Because I have a bunch more stuff. If we take a look at kind of the top things that are in the system, I think that there's a couple that aren't over here. And I wish I could see them from both sides. There needs to be a mirror block. But, yeah, see, we have quartz, granite, gravel, dirt, stone, schist, nice. There's marble. But this, it looks like there's two different kinds of marble in the system. Let's take a look at that. That is really weird. No, not down here. Slip, you big derp. Yeah, we got 44,000 of 2746 and then 35,000 of 776 colon 2. And we're not going to really, I don't think we're going to use a unifier or anything to convert these. I guess we could. It might be easier than creating two deep stores. And I really would like them to all be under a single ID, and preferably the 2746. Not from Geostrata, from the Chisel mod would be better. But at the end of the day, regardless, we have the deep store set up. It's really pretty cool. I think that the system looks good. And right now I have my night vision turned off. And I thought we'd have a little fly around so you can see. It's looking good, right? It's looking pretty cool. We got to figure out some ways to fit some more stuff and things in here. Assembly table is going to be an interesting kind of deal because I don't want to clog up the center passage any further. I've already clogged this up, so you can't go up right here, which is fine. I mean, we can just go up here, come inside of here, and then if you go in the center, you can move up through like a scaffolding here to work on different stuff and things. But I want to be able to move. See, I think this would be a great place to have the assembly table, but I've got to be able to get to the top here. This is where we're going to be starting to build an outer like observation area, observation deck. And then I'm also going to build four supports that are going to come down. I talked about that a little bit in the last episode. That's going to be a big project, and I want to do them on the diagonal, so it's going to be a little bit tricky. It would be much easier to do them on the 90s, but you know what? I just don't like easy. It's just too easy to have it be easy. So I wanted to do it in the difficult way. So I think we're going to do it on the diagonals. But yeah, we've got the system set up. Everything's working. I really like it. I hope you guys do too. If you like the new kind of configuration, leave a thumbs up and let me know. But yeah, so I'm not sure we got anything else to do today. Let me take a look around. I'll be right back. So I was just looking at the time, and that's about all the time we have for today, guys. So I feel like we got a lot accomplished. We got the Mac moved over. We got the drives moved over. We got our pages moved over. We got everything basically moved over. Now we can kind of start to use this as our main base. We got a couple more things I want to get going, but I feel pretty good. We have a really solid start. So yeah, I'm excited about it. If you liked the video, please don't forget to hit the like button and show your support to Feed the Beast. Feel free to share and favorite the video as you see fit. Don't spam it on Reddit. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day.